to tell about this guy you all know me and he's scared as hell. He comes to me at night after I crawl into bed. He's burnt up like a weenie and his name is Fred. He wears the same hat and sweater every single day. And even if it's hot outside, he wears it anyway. He's home when I'm awake, but he shows up when I'm asleep. I can't believe that there's a nightmare on my street. If I remember it right, and we had just gotten back off tour last night. So the gang and I thought that it would be groovy if we summon up the posse and dumb rush the movie. I got Angie, Jeff got Tina, Ready Rock got some girl I've never seen in my life. That was alright though, cause the lady was chill. Then we dipped to the theater, set to Ill, buggin', Cole having a ball. And something about Elm Street was the movie we saw. The way it started was decent, you know, nothing real fancy about this homeboy named Fred and this girl named Nancy. But word, when it was over, I said, yo, that was death. And everything seemed all right when we left. But when I got home and laid down to sleep, that began the nightmare on my street. In my room like an oven, my bed soaked with sweat, and man, I was bugging. I checked the clock, and it stopped at 12:30. It had melted, it was so darn hot, and I was thirsty. I wanted something cool to quench my thirst. I thought to myself, yo, this heat is the worst. But when I got downstairs, I noticed something was wrong. I was home all alone, but the TV was on. I thought nothing of it as I grabbed the remote. I pushed the power button, and then I almost choked when I heard this awful voice coming from behind. It said, man, I ain't even wait to see who it was. Broke outside in my drawers and screamed so long, cuz got halfway up the block, I calmed down and stopped screaming, then thought, oh, I can't, I must be dreaming. I strolled back home with a grin on my grill. I figured since this is a dream, I might as well get ill. I walked in the house, the big bad fresh prince. But Freddy killed all that noise real quick. He grabbed me by my neck and said,
here's what we'll do. We got a lot of work here, me and you. The souls of your friends, you and I will claim.
I said, yo, Fred, I think you got me all wrong. I ain't partners with nobody with nails that long. Look, I'll be honest, man, this team won't work. The girls won't be on you, Fred, your face is all burnt. Fred got mad and his head started steaming. But I thought, what the hell, I'm only dreaming. I said, please leave, Fred, so I can get some sleep. But give me a call and maybe we'll hang out next week. I pat him on the shoulder, said, thanks for stopping by. Then I opened up the door and said, take care, guy. He got mad, drew back his arm and slashed my shirt. I laughed at first and thought, hold up, that hurt. It wasn't a dream, man, this guy was for real. I said, Freddy, how's been an awful mistake here. No further words, and then I darted upstairs. Crashed through my door, then jumped on my bed. Pulled the covers up over my head, said, oh, please do something with Fred. He jumped on my bed, but threw the covers with his claws, tried to get me. But my alarm went off, and then silence. It was a whole new day, I thought. I wasn't scared of him anyway, until I noticed those rips in my sheets, and that was proof that there had been a nightmare on my street. Come on, Jeff, answer! Come on, man.
Hello?
Jeff, it's Prince, man. Jeff, wake up! Jeff, wake up!
What do you want?
Jeff, wake up, man. Listen to me, Jeff.
It's 3 o'clock
Jeff,
in the morning.
Listen,
what
Jeff,
do you
would
want?
You listen to me? Whatever you do, don't fall asleep.
Man.
Jeff, listen to me.
So,
don't go to sleep, Jeff.
I'll talk to you tomorrow. Jeff, I'm going to bed.